Hi guys, 12:30 in the afternoon, lunchtime, whatever. Not done a lot this morning. Been watching a Bills T-Max video, almost an hour and 20 minutes long. Another mini excavator bucket. He likes to weld, so I don't blame him. That's what he likes doing. Right. I just saw a post from North Norfolk Radio on Facebook. And I'll read it out to you. It says, "Good morning from Greg. I have to play Macarena later as part of the rewind. Excuse me. Just wondering whether the Macarena is the worst dance-along record ever. Or would that be a Saturday Night by Wigfield, or even Oops Upside Your Head, or something else entirely?" Now, the thing is with songs like that, they're designed as one-hit wonders. Which basically means, you know, they're designed to be catchy, have a catchy dance, sell loads of records, and then they disappear into the sunset. But are they really that bad? Because I remember when I was in high school, we used to have the high school disco once a month. Stupid songs like the Macarena and whatnot would just get everybody up on the dance floor and dancing. So, are they really that bad? They're obviously doing what they intended to do, and people obviously liked them. And even if they didn't, you still couldn't help but dance along, or, you know, nod your head or whatever, because they were so catchy. But, like I said, that's the whole point of them. Anyway. Just been, well, I've taken all the wiring off of this high voltage capacitor. Now it's got a 2100 volt rating on it, so yeah, I don't recommend sticking your fingers on the end of them contacts when one of these is charged. I've got another one here. This one's actually slightly bigger physically. I think this one's actually the larger rating, is it? Yeah, one microfarad, or one UF, whatever that is. I can't remember off the top of my head now. Oh, this one's only a little bit smaller. This is only 0.9. Plus 3%, whatever that is. Is that plus 3%? Yep. Made in Ningbo, China. Ningbo. Both made in the same place, so they're probably made in the same factory, actually. Made in Ningbo, China, but came out two entirely different microwaves. So I presume these microwave manufacturers probably just use the same factory in China that makes these. 50 to 60 hertz, no PCBs. I presume that would mean you can't put these on a circuit board. Considering it's 2100 volts, I don't think I'd want to. You're likely to blow something up on the circuit board. Anyway, moving on. It's a bit of a dull day outside. I had a bit of a spitting session earlier. It wasn't really raining, but sort of like a spit, and I just realised a bird has shat right across my window. Thank you. And it's right where I can't reach to clean it either. Bastards. I'm going to have to rely on the rain and weather just to wear that off the window. Yeah, that's the problem with these windows. I can't reach. Even leaning out of that window, I still can't reach. Anyway, look what I found. I found the other one. Oddly enough, it was still in the carrier bag of parts that I brought home from Mum's. I just never took it out. I thought I did. So the one I had lurking around in here, I must have picked up and put on the bike and just completely forgot that I hadn't emptied the carrier bag of parts, because that was still in there with a few other parts actually. I'm going to take those off and just give the forks a clean, because they're all mucky inside here, so I might do that later. Crack on and get some work done on the Magna in the bedroom. I think I'll probably swap bikes around to do that. Possibly. Oh dear. Oh. Yeah. Right. Yeah. I've already been out to Lidl's today. I haven't been anywhere. So, what I'm going to do, I might throw the radio on for a bit. Just take those V-brakes off the front here and just clean the inside of those forks. It'll be easier. Might even actually, if I can find some spray or something, I'll clean the frame down as well. Might as well do that. Get the freewheel on the wheel. Oh, I forgot to turn it upside down to take the back wheel out. I might as well take the front wheel out as well, and that might actually save having to take the brakes off. I sod it if I take the brakes off as well. It just means I haven't got to try and squeeze a cloth in between them, have I? Yeah, I'll do that then. And once it's all cleaned, it's ready to go together when I've got all the parts. What did I do with that 7-speed that's in that bag? That's alright then. Tools to do that job are all down there. See, if I had somewhere decent to sit this camera, I'd leave it running while I was tinkering with this, and this will give you something to watch. Right. What about if I move this chair over this side? I'm smashing my Lego model again. What about if I sit that on there? What's the angle like? I don't know though, because my battery's getting low, I may not have enough. Alright, what I'll do, I'll use this angle and I'll show you the work I'll be doing on the other bike then. So, I'll do this one off camera and I'll do the other one on camera. So, that's going to be the easiest option. So while I'm off camera, this can be charging. I've just come over to the PC because I used the USB to charge it. Hey, I've got no eyes. That's better. Give the LCD a bit of a clean. Right. I'll disappear then and I'll see you all in a little while. Okay. Camera's charged and I've been a busy bee. Got the Claude. Claude 2 is all cleaned and ready to be assembled when I have the parts. Pardon me. But I have bought in the Magna and I found a single speed crank that fits. Well, I say single speed. What it actually is, if I just park my ass on the floor, it's one of these. It's a type of crank where you can change the individual chain rings. So I've got a spare there, I've got a bigger spare there. This one, which I picked up, the chain rings are all knackered. In fact, they're egg-shaped instead of round. But I just wanted the screws. So those are actually spare parts I didn't need. This is one I already had made up as a single speed, which coincidentally fits perfectly because I was originally going to use that one, which is the one I was going to put I'm Cat's Customs Trikes, racing bike, road bike, which I can still do now. I don't need it. That wouldn't fit anyway because the chain ring's too big. So, try and get this nut started on here. I've just got to find a couple of pedals. I'm hoping I can take the pedals off of the crank set that was already on here. That's what I'm hoping, if they come off. If not, I'm going to have to find a pair. No, the chain, it's not jammed. I've just I've sat it on top of the bottom bracket. What can I do? Here we go. Is that going to work? Sort of. You might move because you're on my lap. Yeah, the other chain ring is too big. I suppose that would be off balance because that's a steel crank the other side, isn't it? Crank it on tighter if I have to. Later. See if I can get the chain hook on. If I have to lengthen the chain, then I'll have to lengthen it, which I've got a feeling I am going to have to. That's far too short. So I'm guessing this probably had a smaller chain ring originally than that, but... So I've got a middle one there, but all the teeth, you see, there's one chipped there. Oh, here's the other one. I'll put that on the other side. Gear cable's on. It's the original gear cable. I'll just change the grip shift. I found a couple of brake levers. Got the V-brakes bolted on. So what I've got to do is... This is actually nearly there. Fit a couple of links in the chain just to lengthen it. I know I've got a match of a chain somewhere. Connect the gear cable up. Whack on a couple of pedals. Give it a clean. I was going to change the seat post, but I haven't got anything better, so I'm going to have to clean it up as best I can. Sort of back the inner tube out in this back wheel because it's flat as a pancake. It didn't hold air. Brake cable shouldn't be a problem. Shouldn't need a very long one for the rear brake here, in theory. Okay, yeah, we're nearly good to go for this one. I've just got to put the other crank arm on. Make sure the thread on these pedals will actually fit. That's going to be a problem, I think. Ain't going to fit, is it? It might. I'll have to see if I can take it off and just try it. If not, I might have to see what I've got in my box of pedals. Downstairs, but I'm actually glad I kept hold of this. That's the whole reason I keep these cranks that you can, well, you can basically change the chain ring size and number. You could have one like this one. It's got the mounts on there for the another two, but I only put the one on there because I set it up deliberately as a single speed. For another project, actually, and it wouldn't fit. So, I went for that. I went for that on this bike, as I already had it there, and I was hoping it would fit without rubbing on the frame. That's why the other one over here is too big. It rubs on the frame. So, I'll crank that down. So I think the pedal on that side would fit, but I'm not sure. That's knackered anyway, that one. That one's alright.
Okay.
What does that say on there? No, actually free wheels nicely, but when I get that in the first gear, that derailleur is going to be like over here somewhere. I guarantee it. I could try it as it is, but nah. I know from the position of that derailleur that it needs at least three links put in it, which I'll do. Get as much of this done as I can. I've got some steel wool somewhere. I can just clean that seat post down with. I'm going to need my extractor to pull the crank off the other side. I'll crank this down again just to make sure it's on there nice and tight. Might as well just show you the clawed quickly. Oh, bloody hell. She's cleaned up quite nicely now. Right, so I can start gathering some more parts. I need seat post. I'm gonna change the stem later because it really doesn't look right with the handlebars all the way up there, so I'm gonna change it. I've got most of the dirt off. You found my shift cleaning spray, so I've used that. And that was all, that was filthy in that area down there, and I've cleaned it all off. Oh, wrong way. Still got a sticker there. Still had the original sticker on the original forks as well, so I doubt this thing was actually used a great deal. I've got a feeling that it was one of them bikes that was bought and then stood outside, not used. It's a shame when people do that. Right, I'm gonna disappear and get some more done. Get the crank the other side. I think the next job is I'll put the other crank arm on, the left side on. And that job's done. And I can perhaps attach the gear cable and just see if the gears are going to work. So I'll be back. Yeah, I don't know. I'll be back sometime later. It's 20 past three now. Anyway, time to get my ass into gear. Right. Everything's working. Gears I've still got to fiddle around with, but I've got to lengthen that chain still. Found a couple of pedals. The ones from the original crank set did fit, so bit of WD-40 on one and that freed it off. Brakes are all working. It's just that puncture. That's all I've got. Oh, and just to sort that out. I just got to tighten the screw up, that's all. But yeah, sort the flat tire out and it's good to go. Nearly. Let's give it a clean down. But yeah, then that'll be good to go. I'll find some screws to put in here so I can adjust the springs. Well, that works, so I've just got to adjust the brake pad this side because it's rubbing on the tyre. That's no good, is it? You don't want friction when you're trying to ride along. You want friction when you want to. Ah. Might need some wheel adjustment in there. Look at that. That's not meant to be like that because the wheel is too far to the left. There's a couple ways I can fix that. Might have to take, well, I've got to take the back wheel out, so I might as well fix it. I mean readjusting the rear brake, but eh, who cares? If I got to adjust it, I got to adjust it. Right. But having it sitting at that angle is going to bug me. Let alone the person riding it, and it looks odd as well, so. Alright, and so, we're nearly done anyway, just a, the tuning up, as it were, to do, you know, and adjustments. I was thinking of putting a zip tie around that just to keep that to the frame to keep it tidy, but the other option I've got is to put a small brake noodle on it, which I might do actually. That might work a bit better. Let's have a look at my pot of noodles. Pot of noodles. Oh, I've got my George on because I'm about to put some chicken on. Yeah, put a light on. I've got one in there, but that's too long. No. Chuck those up there for a minute. Put one of these over the back. Here it is. Have I got one? I think I have. I've got some rusty flexible ones as well in here. I'm not very keen on the flexible ones myself, though. Yeah. I can try this one on it. That might work a bit better, actually. But I don't actually think I've got a smaller one. Other than that one. I don't think. Yeah, I've got the horrible flexible one there. I don't think that's going to work as well. I'll try that one after I've had something to eat. I've got a pile of tubes there. I'm going to fix the puncture in one of them because they're all punctured. And tuck that in the wheel. Obviously check the tyre hasn't still got something in there that'll puncture the tube. And check the rim tape. Rim tape is actually looking fine around this end. I think it is just punctured. Right, yeah, and just adjust that wheel. What I'll do to bring the wheel this way, I can adjust or take this lock nut off. That's in there. We might find my hand. Where is it? There it is. And put a thinner one on, like the one that's on this side. I've lost my hand again. There we go. And that means that the wheel will come this way a bit more. I could, if I have to, well, that's another option. I could put a narrower spacer on, but I'll get those bits after dinner, because all I've got to do is grab the tin. Are they in a tin? What did I put all those in? Yeah, they're still in a tin through there. All my wheel axle spares and whatnot. Right, so we've been heating for 5 minutes. I'm going to lift that up. Grab the chuck. Get rid of that and put me there somewhere. Run hot. Do the bin bag. Forgot to do the bin bag. Crank the timer back round to max, which is 20 minutes. And the bubba's your uncle. Refuse sack in the bin. Do the catch tray after dinner as well, because that needs doing. Can't think of anything else that needs doing. I'm not going to film doing the catch tray though. That's just, yeah. Who wants to see that? Okay. That's cooking. This could go and soak under the sink. Ah, fucking water's hot. Mum said I don't wash up in hot water. Can you see that steam coming off there? Yeah, my water gets fucking hot. The council set the thingy on the tank. 60 degrees, I believe. And I've just left it. I've been tempted to turn the thing down a little bit because it really is friggin' hot. But now I've just left it as it was. Right. Still got those chickens to pack up. Could do that tomorrow. Ready for Thursday. Raised the stem on this. I was going to change it, but I haven't got one with a small enough diameter here that fits. So I just actually raised it, and it does look a darn sight better. Cleaned it up as best I can. There's a rust patch there that I think it's a rust patch anyway. I don't know, it's a bit of dirt. Ooh. Glue or something. There we go, that's cleaned off. My steel wool wouldn't touch it for some reason, so I thought that was like a rust patch. So I've just got to go over it in places to give it a little clean up. We'll just go over this chrome here and clean it up. Give it a clean down with my shift cleaner. Usually I use a can of furniture polish, but I don't know where mine's disappeared to. So, getting there with this one. This was actually really, really easy to do. I wouldn't have needed to put the V-brakes on if I hadn't nicked them to put on the Claude. That would have been one less job to do. And if I didn't swap the handlebar with the girls' one I just sold, because the girls' one had a really stupid, weird handlebar on it that didn't suit it, so I changed it. And the only one I had at the time over at Mum's was on this. So, you know, all that shit on that seat post, but I can't get that off, unfortunately. Mole Catcher. That was my nickname at high school, that was. Mole. Mole or Moley. Haven't been called that in years, though. And those kids that used to chant, I am a mole and I live in the hole. Pardon me. Oh, he started hurting. Right, well, I'm going to go and watch this, I hope. While my chuk-chuk is cooking, so I'll talk to you all later on. I do believe it's done. Front brake has given me a few issues. I may change those two V-brake bits for another two, but rear brake, I've sorted that. Back tyre is pumped up. I couldn't find a puncture in the tube, but I have had to replace the back wheel. There's a couple of reasons why I did that. One, the axle is bent badly. And the second reason is it's got a freewheel on it that I do not have the tool for to remove it. So I can't fix the axle without that tool. Where did I put the wheel? Is it not in here? Is it in the bedroom? It might be in the bedroom. No, it's still a disappearing act. What have I done with it? I did find my can of polish as well. It was in here, on the floor. I can't miss it. It's a fucking big round black wheel. I don't think I put it out on the landing. Did I? I don't know. Well, I'll be. I can't find a fucking wheel now. A big black round wheel, and I can't find it. Oh, for pity's sake. What have I done with it? Ah! It's hidden up here, that's why I couldn't see it. wheel is still good. It's just, if I just lean it up on the bike, you can see. See that? I need a special tool that has two notches on it, which I don't have. I've just got the standard freewheel removal. What make is this? Made in Taiwan. Can't quite read it, but the wheel is fixable. I can put another axle in it and whatnot, so I just need to get that freewheel off. But for now, well, it's all right as it is. I might see if I can actually find an alloy front wheel just to put in the front, just so it's got a matching pair. I didn't want to. I was hoping to leave the wheels in it that came with it, but that ain't gonna happen. I could leave those wheels like that. I've got I've got a very similar front wheel downstairs. So I can put a very similar pair on this. It does mean I'm going to have to empty half the shed to get to it, but my wooden shelf up on the right-hand side has decided to fall off the wall. So I've got that to fix as well. Well, if I'm going to change the front wheel, then there's no point in me setting the brake up yet, then, is there? Well, I suppose I could change the brakes over. So, pretty much, as long as that back tire stays up overnight, change the front wheel tomorrow and sort that front brake out, and that's done. Gears are working, everything else is working fine, you know, the rear brakes are working, it's not rubbing, you know, it's the thing I had to adjust as well because it was rubbing, and I've put a small one of those on. So it's a little bit more discreet and out of the way, just so whoever's riding it don't catch her bloody leg on it, because that's annoying. Won't hurt, it's just annoying. Been there, done that. Got the t-shirt, and I keep forgetting to spray that epoxy. I bought this up specifically to spray the stem on the on Claude 2. Claude the second. Hello, Claude the second. So I was just going to give it a squirt of this. Preferably before I run out of it. Trying to do this all one-handed is not easy. I'm going to give it a squirt this side as well. And we'll just let that soak for a bit, and I'll give it one last try. I might as well. If WD-40 won't make it shift, then it probably isn't ever going to shift. Oops. It's one of the VCRs I'm going to free cycle. Do you know anyone that wants a VCR? It works. Same as that one, but I think the display has failed on that one, so I might actually use that one as a take apart. I will plug it in and just double check, but there is a remote control with it. One thing I've decided to do, because it's cheap, and in fact I'll do it now, I've had that Carrera hybrid bike sitting on my landing. It's got to be over 6 months now because I haven't found a hanger for it, but what I'm going to do, I'm just going to quickly go on eBay while I've got you on, or got the camera on. Go into my eBay. I'm going to buy one of these. It's an emergency hanger. The idea is it fixes to the frame using your wheel, so it's not designed as a permanent thing, but I've sort of figured if this actually works as I like, then it's just going to be me riding a bike, which means if it's going to be a faff around to get, you know, a puncture fixed or something because of this. Because obviously if I take the wheel off, that's going to come off with it. But I'm thinking at £7.80, free P&P, should I give it a whirl? And even if it doesn't work, I've got something there that can get me out of a muddle on another bike, haven't I? 99.8% positive feedback. 6,574 feedback score. It's more than 10 in stock. It's free postage, so... But it's the sort of thing I think you're supposed to put like in your bag or your pouch or whatever, bum bag or whatever you're using, and take it with you in case yours snap. Oh. He's got 3,729 positive feedback over the last 12 months. 11 neutral. I'm not fussed about neutral, personally. 6 negative. Is any of that recent? Not looking at this. No, there's nothing on page 1. There's 25 items per page. Let's change that to 50. Do we see any red? No. He's done a lot of trade during the past month as well. You know what? So I can get that bike done, I think I'm going to go for it. I know I want to spend that money on Lego, but, well, I still can. This has only this isn't even taken half of what I've got in PayPal. About a third. Yeesh. Alright then, click, buy it now. I will happily have one of those from you, please, sir. Well, I could add postage to it, or Royal Mail First Class 149, but I'm not in any hurry for it, so I'll stick with the free postage. That'll probably come in a little jiffy bag. Go. So that can be my next project as soon as that part arrives. That's the cheapest one on here as well. It's just like a cheap alternative, get you out of a muddle thing. I know I'm planning to use it as a permanent thing when it's only meant as temporary, but like I said, I intend to keep the bike, so it's only me that's got to piss around if I get a flat tire or a puncture, which isn't often with me, touch wood. Touch word, I don't want to talk that up. In fact, when my Claude Butler got a puncture on the way back from Cat's Custom Trokes the other week, that's the first one I've had in years, to be honest. Look at that. An old 1990s Lego set, early 1990s, just went for £23 exactly. 7 bids. It's mad. Did you just fart, Cat? I heard something hiss from down there. He's there. Oh dear. Yeah, I've decided not to play with the soldering iron today. I got pissed off burning myself yesterday. And there's nothing to take apart at the moment anyway. I think I took most of it down to the bin earlier. Scary me. And, yeah. At least... the Magna is nearly done. It's a nice looking bike. I may actually just give it a clean down now that I've found the polish. It's a nice quiet task I can do. Just pile my tools up over here. What's the time? It's nearly 8:30. Yes, so I don't really want to be dropping tools on the floor, do I? Right. He's got a thing for sitting on carrier bags. If I leave a sheet of paper or a carrier bag on the floor like that, he'll go sit on it. Weirdo. I'm guessing it's his dinner time. And I suppose I could bolt on the new calipers if I really wanted to. It's a non-noisy job. I've got parts in this bag that's got to go downstairs again. And I have got some more. Yeah. This one's lost the spring. It doesn't matter because I've got a tray for the springs in the cupboard. Here's another one. That's a different one. I've got black, but I don't really want to do like two black, two silver. I'd rather keep them all the same. That one's got a spring in it. It goes with that one. There should be one more silver one in here, not as a break end of a brake lever. Well, should have had another one up here to go with this. I'm sure I bought two up, because I was going to use it on here. It's not, no, I can't see it kicking around over here. It wouldn't be far away if it was up there. I've got to clean that one up, but if I use these have got the adjusting screws in there for the spring tension, so I can set up the front. Those ones have not got them. They've fallen out. Maybe I'll go and get the tray which I've got full of springs. Or is it out here? Is it this one? No, it's not. Pardon me. Right, I'm going to do that and give this a clean up and I might as well show you when it's all nice and clean and sparkly. Be back in a bit. Right, well, I've got as far as I can with the Magna, which I'll show you in a bit. But I did remember that on an extension cord my Cat's Custom Trikes gave me the other week, is this unusual plug. Unusual because, well, not only is it old and brown, but it's got a switch on the top. Now, for all I know, there could be an eight-legged friend hiding in there. So, part of me isn't actually looking forward to opening this. If it will open. It'll open. We can have a look inside. Holy crap. I was going to get... There's the exoskeleton of a spider, or spider skin, whatever you want to call it, but... Jesus Christ, I've never seen a plug wired so badly in all my life. Look at that. There's not even a fuse in it, there's just... Well, I'm not too sure if that's fuse wire, or paperclip, or... Ew, that... It's not an extension cable, there's not even any, an earth connection on it. I mean... Look at this. Look at it. That is bad. That's one of the worst plugs I've opened up. which is just as well I did before plugging it in, and I wouldn't have recommended using it in that condition, because that is abysmal. Trying to get these wires off. See what he's done. I'm not actually sure how he's managed to do it though. Brass washer in there, getting in the way. There we go, got that one off. Yeah, that's a bit on the excessive side. I didn't need all that much. Yeah. I have to say, it's just one of the worst plugs I've ever owned. At least the wires are around the right way. That's okay. That's a good thing. Holy moly. I think that's just gone down by my feet. Light would be useful. Might be a red light, but it's still a light. Holy. That really is the worst I've taken apart in a very long time. Well, I know when I cut the lead off, something fell out the bottom of the plug. I'm not sure what it was. I don't think it was alive, whatever it was. But, this is actually a pretty old plug. Probably wouldn't recommend using it these days. It's just interesting because it's got the switch. And I've also noticed, I don't know if it's going to show up, but where the live goes, there's a little red dot right here by my finger. Where the earth goes, there's a little green dot. And where the neutral goes, there's a little black dot. Back in the days when a lot of cable over here were just those colours, red, black and green. But, yeah. I don't even think that's even fuse wire, to be honest. Might be. It might be. I'm not 100% sure if that's actually a piece of fuse wire or just a random piece of wire put in there. And, yeah, I'm going to put the cover back on. Jeez. I'm actually thinking I should go and get the other extension lead while I'm doing this. And check the plug and socket on the other one. Shall I go and get that one? Shall we have a look at that one? I'll pause for a minute, I think. Okay. So I've got the extension lead now, which is, rest of it is down there. I don't actually know how long it is, I just know it's long. But if I was actually doing a pat test on this, it would fail instantly because of that. Because what they've done, whoever wired this, you can just see the colours there, they've, instead of cutting the inside wires to length and doing it properly, they've just taped it over. So, I'm going to take the back cover off again, and hope there's nothing living in it, because I do have a little bit of arachnophobia, so... Hopefully there's nothing living in it. Anything? Nope, this is good and clear. Anything on the lid? Nope. Well, apart from that, the inside of the plug actually passes. This one's been done properly. So maybe they were wired by different people, you know. I don't know. I don't know, but whoever wired this one up really did bodge it. But this one, yeah, this is fine. Apart from that bit, which isn't really good, I'll redo that bit. Yeah, it's got the correct size fuse in there. All the wires are correctly wired. So, yeah, that is a pass. Well, the actual connections are a pass. I'm just going to disconnect it, though. Oh, that screw was a little bit loose. But as hard to believe as it might be, screws like these can actually just loosen off over time. Especially in a plug, with a plug, you know, being knocked around and dropped and, you know, that can, I thought this was aluminium wire for a second there, but I think it's just alloy coated, because I can see gold underneath the alloy. It doesn't matter. Well, not to me it doesn't, you know. If it plugs in and turns on, then that's all that matters. But yeah, I will snip this off. This actually feels like it's rubber insulated. This doesn't feel like PVC. So one thing I will do before I reinstate this as an extension cord is just to go along the insulation and scare the crap out of Nemo as well. He's not liking this. I've got no use for a great big long extension lead like this. Oh, there's another patch. I will take that off there and just investigate that. Got all sorts entangled into this. But I do recommend, if you're going to get anything secondhand electrical, especially from, I don't know, a car boot sale or something, where you know for a fact it hasn't been tested, just double check it. Because, well, as you've seen with that switched plug over there, the MK brand. I might do a separate video on that one day. Okay, I was going to sit and untangle this, but I'll do that off camera, I think, because it's just going to take bloody ages. Somehow I've managed to get one of my power adapters entangled into this as well. See if I can get it untangled and at least get that out of the friggin' way. How, I don't know, but I have managed it. Ow. That fell onto my knee. There we go. Are we free? We're free. Whee! Right, where's the socket? There's the socket. There you go. Standard 3-pin British socket. In fact, I do believe some of my extension leads I've made have used the exact same one as this. Has it got brand on it? Nope. 13 amp, 250 volt. Ooh. That's showing its age there. Not many things have 250 volts printed on it these days. It's usually 220 to 230. Might get up to 240 in some places. Haven't undone the screws and half, you plum. There we go. Oh, ooh, good and clean in here as well. This end looks alright. The only part I will do is just trim these wires short, because as you can see, This outer insulation is meant to be under the cord grip. Because, well, you can see why, look. And the wires are moving. But again, apart from that, all the wires are terminated fine, although that screw for that neutral terminal looks like it's pretty far undone. No, it is done up. Interesting. Very interesting. Well, before I re-terminate the socket and plug onto this cable, I need to check the cable. So, I do think that's something I'll either do later, or just do it off cable, because that's going to be a really boring thing to do. Because I've got to untangle the damn thing as well. But it'll be a bit easier if I take the socket and the plug off. I'm still in good enough condition to use. They don't look pretty, but they're not, you know, sort of damaged to the point they're in a dangerous state. Oh, there's some cobwebs in there. Yeah, I don't think I could actually do with a reel or something to roll that cable up on. Anyway, that's that bit done. Yeah. I've got the bike upside down. That's just as well I'm changing the front wheel anyway. Hang on. Got armpit hair getting stuck because the front brake doesn't sit square of the wheel either side like that. They're both leaning over that way because I don't know if I can get a good shot of it, but you might be able to just make out that the front wheel is too far over to the right. It's not sitting centre of the forks as it should be. So hopefully I've got a similar wheel to this one down in the shed. I'll grab that tomorrow and I'll change it, and hopefully that'll sit a bit more central in the forks and fix the brake problem, and then all problems with this bike will be fixed. The gears are working, rear brakes work, and front brake is technically working. And I was actually wrong. I thought the spring adjuster screws here were missing. They weren't. They were just screwed all the way in on both brakes. So I just unscrewed them so I can actually set them up properly now. I do believe there's a fit. No, or is that the tar? No, I think that's a wonky tar. I don't actually think I'd pump the tires up on this bike because this front wheel isn't rock solid with air. So I've got a funny feeling what I thought was actually a punctured back tire I never actually pumped up in the first place. Duh. But yeah, I've got a similar wheel to this in the shed. It just doesn't have that blue sticker on it. That's pretty much the only difference. It's a nice wheel and I was keeping it because it was a nice wheel, but what the hell am I going to use it for? Oh yeah, and the other thing I did, I put a couple of extra links in that chain, so yeah, the derailleur is still sitting in that position, but that's because it's on first gear, not sixth. It used to sit in that position on sixth gear, so it's improved a lot. Can oil the chain when I take it down tomorrow. Could actually take the bike downstairs tomorrow and change that wheel, to be honest. I don't need to. Probably make more sense, actually, because I've got to take it downstairs to photograph. I've ran over it with the can of polish and just cleaned it up a bit. That reminds me, I've got a dust cap somewhere to go on that back wheel. And my desktop background has stopped scrolling. It should scroll through all the photos in the folder. And every now and again, and it used to do it on Windows 7 as well, so it's not a Windows 10 thing. It just stops for some reason. No idea why, but like I said, it used to do it on Windows 7 as well, so, yeah. It's just one of them random things. It's not hugely important, is it? Right, I think the tires are right. I think they're both Sabre tires. Yep. There's enough tread on them. They're not hugely great tread, but they're not bald either. Bits of this stuff all over this where stepdad was planing wood. Stepdad, in his infinite wisdom, I can't remember if I've actually told you about this. Here's a little story anyway. My stepdad, in his infinite wisdom, to save money and whatnot, like everybody wants to do these days, found an American style fridge freezer free on Gumtree. It's free to a good home. Now you've got to remember that American style fridge freezers, fridge at the bottom, freezer on the top on this one, are a lot wider than our standard, normal, British, well I say normal, I should say, than our British ones. Our British ones are sort of tall and narrow, whereas American ones tend to be shorter, probably only a little bit taller than me actually, but they're a lot wider. So, the only way he could get it in the cupboard under the stairs was to take the architrave out. The door frame, if you will, if you want to call it that. But, he thought that's a fairly straightforward job, you know, you just take the architrave out, put in some new bits of wood, presto, done. No! Half the plaster fell off the wall with it. So he ended up having to re-plaster all the walls inside the, cupboard under the stairs, and then plane the wood to replace the architrave with, just so as he could get this epoxy fridge freezer in, and then we couldn't get it in the back door either. I actually had to take the back door off because I would actually say that their back door is actually narrower. No, it is actually probably about the same width as this. It's quite a narrow door. Now you'd expect doors to be quite wide like that one, or if not a bit wider, you know, the main doors to your house. Nope, because the house is a very old farmhouse that probably dates back to something like, I don't know, 1600s, 1700s ish, maybe older, maybe a little bit newer, I don't know, but somewhere around there, it's everything is small, you know, the ceilings are low, the doors are small and narrow, so had to take the door off to get the damn thing in, and then we had to take all the door hinges off the front and the doors off the front of the fridge freezer. Then we had to take the, well, I think it's a vent thing, off the bottom. Then we had to take the drain off for the defrost feature. Comes down from the freezer and just runs into a tray at the bottom of the fridge freezer and just naturally evaporates with the heat of the compressor at the bottom. That's what it does. That's how they stay frost free. Well, we took it off anyway because it was busted. Someone had actually bodged the plastic tube up with a bit of hose pipe. They'd obviously cracked it themselves at some point and put a bit of hose pipe between the broken bit of plastic tube and the top of the freezer. So my stepdad, in again, you know, being the master of invention, went and grabbed an old washing machine hose and cut the connectors off for the washing machine and just stuck that on the back heater up with a lighter so it would, you know, stretch over the connections. We just stuck that on the back. It works. It's not the sort of conventional factory issue tube, but it still does the same job. So yeah, that was real good fun and games to get that in. Because their old one, that was making some really horrible noises when the compressor kicked in. I think the compressor was slowly on its last legs, because it sounded like a diesel generator running. That's what it sounded like. It was horrible. Anyway, my job for tomorrow, we'll be to swap the wheel over in this bike, Once I've done that, I can go for a quick test ride around the block or something. And get a photo of it, put that up. Is there anything else I've got to do this? But you even see on the bottom, there's only one guide there for one gear cable. There's not one here for any front gear, so. And like I said, there's no mark on the frame where a front derailleur was, so it obviously never had one. So, yeah. I know the suspension works fine. A few dings in the paintwork, but, you know, it's a used bike. It's not brand new. What? That'd be different if it was like a... If I was trying to sell it as a brand new bike, you know, it's got all these dings in it, but... I think it's still got to be worth 30 quid. Once I've just got this front wheel sorted out. That's why I keep lots of odd wheels. Because they do come in useful. Like I said, I hadn't intended to change the wheels on this, but... Because I had to change the back one, just because it made life easier, I just happened to have that back wheel there, which also just happens to fit perfectly in the frame. All I had to do was put a 6-speed freewheel on it. It sort of forced my hand into changing the front one. I don't have to, but silver, black, you know. It'd be alright if I'd changed the back wheel for another black one. It wouldn't be so bad, but... I haven't got another black one. Wait on there, it's only the front wheel. I think the one I've... Is the one I'm thinking of quick release? No, I don't think it is, actually. Shush. Shush. Thank you. Mr. Vogel. Put my bike chain in another tub. Just because the blue one I was using was too small. There is some full length chains in here actually, sort of bundled up. But I don't think I've got one for Claude II. Not yet. Oh, right. It's coming up to 10 o'clock, so I better get this video done and dusted and up on the Facebook. There's a bit of a bonus video earlier today with me pissing around with a soldering iron, which was partly a fail because I kept burning myself. Not with the actual soldering iron, but because I kept forgetting where I'd desoldered stuff from the board. It was still hot. I kept getting hold of it. Duh. So, future reference, actually, what did I do with it? Did I put that away? But, Cat's Custom Trout said she liked the green soldering iron. That's a Parkside brand. I got that from Lidl a couple of years ago, I think, something like that. I think that's the second time I've actually used it. But I have to say, it's not a bad tool. I think it only cost me like £20, something like that. $19.99, I suppose, if I want to be exact. Okay, so I haven't put the soldering iron up there, so where the bloody hell have I put it? Well, actually, before I put the soldering iron in there, I better put the battery charger back. No, I hadn't. I better see if one of them batteries charge. Actually, no. Because I've just remembered I haven't got my... Oh, yeah, I have. Dumbass. It's emergency Alecky, but that'll last till Thursday. Right. Well, I've got a bicycle being collected Saturday, so I was tempted to treat myself to a Lego set, but I don't know what Lego set. Or... No. Just thinking, I still need some Lego parts, don't I? I keep wanting to buy sets though, not parts. Anyway, couldn't do that again, could I? Only Luzda over there out of the way, you know. And in case anyone don't know what the term luzzed mean, you know, throw it somewhere, luzz it. Lots of hand movement off camera like that, I don't know why. Right. So, the rest of my evening is going to be untangle that and possibly reattach the plug and the socket. It wouldn't have been that unsafe to use, I don't think. I wouldn't have recommended it, but it was a darn sight safer than that one. I mean, really? Oh dear. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you liked the video, then please hit the like button and subscribe if you want to. And what was the other one I usually say? My mind's gone blank. Like, subscribe, comment. That's the other one. So yeah, leave a comment. I love comments. Nah, if you've got a comment, then leave one. If you haven't, then don't. And that is it. So I'll talk to you all later. Bye.